origin of Santa Claus begins in the 4th century with St. Nicholas. St. Nicholas was a generous man and loved children. His kindness and reputation for generosity made him so famous that some people even claimed that he could perform miracles. This Dutch American Saint Nick achieved his complete American form in 1823 in the poem A Visit from Saint Nicholas, also known as The Night Before Christmas, by writer Clement Clark Moore, where he also obtained his now famous red and white suit with black boots, belt, and all other things we know about this famous character. Our next song is also from Europe, with its roots in 16th century France. This traditional carol spread throughout Europe and was translated into English in about 1645. This is Sing Me Now Christmas.
Christmas trees have an interesting history as well. In the 16th century, Germany fir trees were decorated with both indoors and out, with apples, roses, candies, and colored paper. In the Middle Ages, fir trees hung with apples were used to symbolize the Garden of Eden in a play called The Paradise Tree. This play usually ended with the prophecy of a savior coming, and so was often performed during the Advent season. Many people believe that the Protestant reformer Martin Luther King adorned trees with light. While Carmen hung one December evening, the beauty of the stars shining through the branches of the fir inspired him to put candles on branches of a small fir tree inside his home, starting what we now call Christmas trees. Our next song is now another traditional one from England. This version is that what we call are very proud of Jingle Bells.
Thank you.
carol dates to the 19th century, but its melody can be traced back to the late 1600s. It is a French organ and was included in a 1703 collection of dances. William Morris wrote this carol when he provided words for the tune around 1860. The melody to masters in this hall is very striking with lots of sounds of Celtic rhythm. We have enjoyed learning this one very much. This is Masters in this Hall.